Muslim Ibn Aqeel, because of this, people left him all alone. They did not think. He lost all his supporters. And then one day, he comes and he prays in the masjid, looks behind, no one is behind him praying. Nobody. He walks out on the streets alone. An old lady takes him in after she recognizes he is Muslim Ibn Aqeel, the ambassador of Imam Husayn, salamullahi alayhi. He spends the night at her place. Then unfortunately her son discovers that Muslim is there. He goes and he tells Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad. They send him the army. The army comes in the morning and starts attacking Muslim ibn Aqeel. He starts fighting bravely. The army keeps on sending to Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad, send us more men and more men. He fights them bravely, and they keep on asking for more men to fight against him. Until Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad said to them, I sent you to capture one man. I did not send you to capture an army. Why do you need so many men? They told him, is this an ordinary man you told us to go capture? This is Muslim ibn Aqeel. This is one of the swords of Bani Hashim. He comes from that noble family, that bravery. He is not an ordinary man. Send us more men. They sent him about 1,000 men just to fight one man. And he fought against them bravely, and they still could not capture him. They still, because haqq, truth is always brave and strong. Batil, falsehood, is always weak and shaken. And hence, it might take more than 1,000 to capture one man, one man. He fought against them bravely until they dug a hole. And he fell into the hole. That's when they managed to capture him. They took him to the palace of Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad. They had an exchange of words. Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad started calling him some names. But Muslim ibn Aqeel, with his integrity and honor, said, my master is Abi Abdullah al-Husayn. Then Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad tells the people, the guards, to go take him up to the palace roof, cut his head off, and throw his body from the top of the palace. Those people who cut heads off today are the followers of such people like Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad. They learned from them. Rasulullah, Amirul Mu'mineen, Ahlul Bayt never did this. Never. Not a single example in history exists with them doing it. It is these men who distorted the whole religion. And those people are following their example. When he takes him to the rooftop, Muslim ibn Aqeel tells the guard, give me a few minutes, let me pray to rak'at salat. It means he was on the state of wudu. It's mustahab, brothers and sisters, always to be in the state of wudu. And to always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He prayed to rak'at salat. Then he got up and turned towards Medina, towards Mecca. And he said, As-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah. This is your cousin Muslim ibn Aqeel, all alone in Kufa. At that time, Imam Husayn had left Mecca. This was on Arafah, on the day of Arafah. He had just left Mecca. It is said, the narrator said, Imam al-Husayn was sitting with a group of people. He got up at that moment and he said, wa alayka as-salamu ya Muslim. And peace be upon you, ya Muslim. Brothers and sisters, every time you say as-salamu alayka ya Aba Abdullah, wherever you are, Imam al-Husayn will respond to you. Just like he responded to Muslim. So every day send your salam to Abi Abdullah. Send your heart to Karbala. For indeed he will remember you. He will greet you back. And then the enemy of Allah struck Muslim once on his neck. Nothing happened to him. He hit him a second time. His head separated from his body. They threw the body of Muslim on the streets and they started dragging him. قدار قضوا ساعة أخبار رموه القوم من قصر الأمور مسلم was all alone غريب in كوفة